Hey, what's up guys? This is Daddy Cool and you are watching Black and White Good God Playthrough. This is episode 3. Just to look back in previous episodes, I have passed Island 1, and in the end of the previous episode we have just arrived to this second island with a possible ally god that will help us to advance in the story, and we have a creature that has just learned a couple of things, and I will try to teach him during this episode even further. So let's go. So here's the god. I mean, he's helping us, and here's my creature. Let's check him. He's tired a bit, okay, but the sun is still up. I think I'm gonna create some disciple people. I mean, I have farmers. I'm gonna make one more
disciple farmer
so that we receive food faster. We have one wall. I do not really want him to sleep too much. We have the nice leash to act nicely. But I think I'm gonna teach him. And we're gonna make a heal for the people, like this. I think I have a couple of water spells as well, so we're gonna make watering. Sooner or later. Oops. Accidentally picked up the villager. I wanted to reward him for creating a water spell, because that's good. Okay, let's check these signs. Done. Other one, nothing in here. Okay. And I think I have to wait till my storehouse is ready. Yo, you are not gonna sleep if you are not that tired. Let's make some exercise.
Good, you have built much. But there is more for you to construct.
I think... No, we can still not advance with the story. So, I wanted to make exercise, yeah. Okay, what you gonna do? Really curious about it. Throw it or put it on the ground? What will happen now? Okay, I'm gonna help you.
We're running out of wood.
Okay, and reward him.
Wood!
Where's he going? I suppose he's going to sleep, maybe? In that case, I think I just let it to happen. Yeah. Okay. Let's check this score.
I have given you an expert builder of worship sites. This building is of great importance. I shall return once you have finished building the worship site.
Ha! Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy! Are we gonna cause some havoc now?
Havoc? No, but it would be good to cast lots of lovely miracles when we need them.
Okay, there is one more thing I would like to check. By the way, it's a different map than the previous episode. And this is the map. We are located in here. This is the ally god and this is the enemy god we have to conquer in this episode. I'm on this map and I would like to check my creature cave. Yeah.
The creature cave. The scrolls display different attributes about your creature. This scroll shows what he's learned to do.
Fill his brain with evil!
Okay, so he learned how to take food from the fields, that's good. Doesn't know how to use the totem, this is a later option. Your character doesn't know how to use the village store. Yeah, that's what I would like to teach him, and that's why I'm binding him usually with the training leash to the storehouse. He has learned how to fish, yeah, that's the main food source. And your creature learned how to dance, and this is also good.
This shows the miracles our creature can cast.
Wow, have a freaking time!
Okay, so I found a lightning spell, and I have taught him the lightning bolt at 2%, so I have cast it only once. And I'm not really sure if I want to teach him 100% because that's an evil spell. I mean, basically you can ruin things with the lightning spell, so it's not really useful. Other than that, yeah, miracle wood is at 19%. The strengthening miracle is 93, so it's not fully learned. But other than that, it's okay.
This scroll shows our creature's state of mind.
His likes and dislikes.
Okay, so he's slightly greedy. That's good because we are. He's getting less and less greedy. Extremely tired, that's a problem, and that's the reason why he would like to sleep, and I think I will let it do. Okay, compassionate and rarely frightened, it's good, and quite playful, also good. I think my god is on the good side, yeah, that's true. And I have paid him a lot of attention. Okay, that's great.
More general information such as his age and height, bless him.
Hey boss, you can change or add tattoos to the creature by clicking on him.
Okay, so he's at 100% health, he is a good person, that's good, he has some energy, moderate strength, that's what I would like to train, zero fatness is very good, exhaustion, and that's what I wanted to check because it doesn't mean he is exhausted, so he's maybe a little bit tired but not exhausted, so I will push him to do some things and not get lazy. Completely healthy. Okay. I think that's all for now. Let's get back to here because he's just hungry and not exhausted. Yeah, and people need food, so I will create a couple of food for them. But first, I would like my creature to eat. Oh, it's and getting dark, so I think it's the best time to let my creature sleep after this.
Construct more buildings.
Our creature is also thirsty. You can drink some water. Great. You can eat some food.
Your Great. People have a desire. Tough for them, but life goes on.
Okay. I would like the creature to go to the creature pen. Come on. Hurry up. Because it's night, you can sleep. And I would like you to sleep a lot at night. Okay, let's give some food to the people. That's great. Okay. In the meantime, food, water, wood.
The power you wield grows.
Okay. Let's check this mission.
Your worship site is built. Now let me teach you how to create miracles. Your people will worship you at the temple. To send them there, you must raise the totem at the village center. You move the hand over the totem. Then you hold down the action button to grab the totem. You move the hand up and down to raise and lower the totem. I've raised the totem so your followers will go to the worship site. The higher you raise the totem, the more people from your village will go to worship you. Now come and look at your followers. They are dancing, worshipping you. This gives you power. These are the miracles that your people offer you. The miracles of grain, wood, and water. To activate one, grab the miracle with the action button and it will be charged by your worshipper. You'll see the energy rings flowing into your hand. When the miracle is charged, it appears in your hand and you are ready to cast the miracle. Remember, worshipping comes at a cost. The needs of your worshippers can be seen on these flags. So, it's good to satisfy these needs and keep your villagers in good health. I'll leave you now to experiment with miracles and expand your influence by growing your village.
Okay. In the meantime, it's morning. And I'm gonna take the creature here. I'm gonna fulfill some needs for the villagers. And I would like my creature to see that The storehouse is getting filled.
Must build homes.
Okay. Okay, he has learned how to use the village store. Wonderful.
Must build homes.
I'm gonna put you into a nice leash. Not sleeping, do something, please. Okay. Worship working food. Let's give them food.
Miracle wood.
Oh yeah, the miracle wood spell. It also has to be taught to the creature.
Must build home.
And I can now create this spell a couple of times without
miracle wood.
The one-shot spells.
Must build homes.
Okay. I'm gonna make here some order, I think. Heal, heal. Food. Let's be quiet for the worshippers. One. Okay, let's check the score.
You are keen to learn the secret of casting miracles. I appreciate your enthusiasm. Come with me. I have set up an area where you can learn more. Here you can learn about defense. And here you can learn to attack. Activate the scroll of your choice.
Let's learn the attack.
Behold, three huts. We shall use these as our targets. Here are some fireballs to use. You hold the action button down, like this. You then move the hand to put momentum on the fireball. You release the action button to cast the fireball. Devastating. Fire spreads and causes serious damage.
Tap the fireball, miracle.
That was low. Maybe this one? Yeah.
Yeah! You hit one of the huts! Fire spreads, you see. A village can be torched in minutes!
My fireball challenge is complete. I have given the knowledge of the fireball miracle to your village. From now on, your people can worship for this miracle at your worship site.
Wow! We can create these now! Bet they'll impress non-believers!
This one as well.
Kazar sent me. I can help you build your settlement up. People are sleeping outdoors as they don't have enough buildings to live in. This is the workshop. I make scaffolding here. It allows you to decide where new buildings should be constructed. If you can supply me with enough wood, I can build a scaffold so that you can plan more houses.
Okay.
Must build homes.
Then let's
draw miracle
some
wood.
Miracle wood here because
must build homes.
This is what we are feeding the building with. And let's put some standard wood as well.
Give me a little more time and I'll turn the wood into scaffolds.
Okay.
Miracle wood.
And also teach the creature how to cast the spell in the meantime.
It looks like your scaffolding is ready. We just need to move it to an area where we want it built. We need to place a scaffold down on the ground.
Miracle wood.
One more spell. Good boy. I'm gonna pay attention to the creature. Every time he is doing something good, I'm gonna reward him.
Miracle wood. Miracle wood.
Okay. Let's create one more house. And a small house as well. Okay, villagers need more food. And this means there are too few people working on the field. That's a child. Okay.
Disciple farmer.
Okay. Let's create one more wood.
Miracle wood.
85. Soon he will learn the spell. Okay, what else? I will teach him for
miracle wood.
100%, and after that we will go further with the story. That's a very useful knowledge as well. Okay.
Miracle wood.
Wonderful. Be a nice guy, please. So what's the plan now? Tell me.
Disciple farmer.
You wanna get some sleep, but let's get some food instead. Come on. Get some food. And he's going in the other direction. If I do not leave him, I mean guide him personal.
When you're happy with its location and angle, click the action button.
Oh, this is such a worthwhile cause. Planning homes to be built for the homeless.
There is another way to solve this homeless problem.
Oh, yes?
Yeah! Kill him!
Okay. Let's do this other quest.
Soon you will need to protect your villages and their buildings. The physical shield protects against objects which are not of a spiritual nature. When you have the miracle, this is how you cast a shield. You move the hand to where you wish to start the shield. Then you hold down the action button and trace the perimeter of the shield, like this. And the shield appears. Now throw these rocks at the hut and watch the shield.
Oops, that was too high. Just like this one. Okay.
See? The hut is protected, but a strong enough attack will destroy the shield. Now you can try. Shield the hut, and I will attack it.
Tap the shield, Miracle, and wait.
Hold the action button and draw a circle on the ground to place the shield.
Hey, you've cast the Miracle! Marvelous!
The shield is ready. The hut survived my onslaught. Well done! Different sized objects do different levels of damage to a shield. It will disappear after taking excessive damage as well. I have given the knowledge of the physical shield miracle to your village. From now on, your people can worship for this miracle at your worship site.
There are still homeless people in the village. You need to build more houses.
Yeah, okay, let's solve this problem with some wood on the building sites. Where the creature? I think, yeah, he's sleeping.
Miracle wood.
Wood. As you can see, we are slowly running out of the wood, and this is not really a good thing, but this is the reason why I have towed the miracle water to the creature. Wood. Because if I place a wood here, and maybe one more here, woodcutters won't cut the wood that is placed inside the village. And if I just cast the miracle water, there you go, wood is being grown, and that can help me later, I mean in the later levels. Okay, here is some more wood as well. We have enough scaffolds. child. Come on.
Construct more buildings.
Be a nice creature. Do something good.
Physical shield.
Or I'm gonna teach you a new spell. Okay, that's gonna be slow. It's only 3% known. So that's a spell that I have to cast a couple of more times till he learns it. But probably also a useful spell. Build.
Disciple Builder. Disciple Breeder.
Okay, that's really nice, but I think I will decide a little bit later what to do with the disciples.
You must have food.
Okay, that's also a good one. He casted a heal spell. You can do it anytime because it gives believers. Oh, I know where are we missing the food. In the worship site. Because they also need food.
Disciple Breeder. Miracle food.
I have a lot of food, so you will receive some more. And
miracle wood.
Let's create the wood.
Your village now truly has more room for people. Building more will encourage growth. This is a village I want to be part of. In my own village, I held the knowledge of the forest miracle. Follow me. Constant worship is needed to maintain it, but the wood it provides is a blessing to the people.
Well, that's a wonderful spell as well.
Miracle Forest.
Let's put it here. Is to not having this spell is take all the wood from it. Let's put a couple of them here, and after that it is cancelled, and we have very lot of wood in return. Let's create
physical shield.
Shield. Where is the creature? Very good. I think he is learning when he is not
physical shield
taking attention to you. So despite. Despite his attention, he learns the spell. I mean, he's increasing the knowledge percentage. Okay, so we are growing, yeah. Just like I said, it's already at 8%. There's another scroll.
Physical shield.
I'm not really sure how can I disable these spells, but... Oh, I know. I have to throw a couple of rocks and they will be disabled. But before that, I'm gonna...
Physical shield.
Create one more. Where's the creature? Not there. And not in here. Not in there. Oh, there you go. Advancing with the story, I think.
You have become well established. Our combined strength is becoming greater. As you near Lethys, it will become more essential to have your miracle skills in top form. For this, you must experience the benefit of gestures. You can charge miracles without having to return to your temple to select them. Move your hand in a spiral like this. Now select the miracle of your choice. Crane is selected like this. All your gestures are summarized at the bottom right of the screen. You try it now.
Okay, so we have this and
miracle food.
Superb! You should practice your gestures. Go and impress this town over here. They look like they're in a bad way. No food or wood. Why don't you create some food for their village store while I supply them with wood? Make sure you have people worshipping at your worship site.
Okay, that's a good idea. Let's create some food.
Miracle food. Miracle food.
But I think, yeah, here we go. Some food. And soon one more.
Miracle food.
Excellent. We have filled the village store and the people are easily impressed. The town needs more impressing before it becomes yours, but I have matters to attend to and shall return later.
Okay, let's find the creature, like this one, maybe once more. Yeah. And... Come on. Because it's night. Yeah. Go home. Okay, give it to sleep. Now it's time to sleep. Wonderful. Okay, heal, heal. Food. Okay.
Okay. Whereas I think
we must build homes.
They still need homes. There you go.
Increase.
Miracle heal. Let's do that. Okay, he's nice sleeping. Pretty long. And that's good. Let's create miracle water. Not in a proper place. The more people see your egg, your acts, the better it is. What have you eaten? Oh, bad boy. You're not eating Yoshi. No, no. Come on. Over there. And sleep inside. Okay, I think I will reward him because it's still night. Okay, and that's your creature is tired. Oh, that's good. From now on your creature will rest more at night. Okay, that has been told for him. I mean, no. Sometimes it's a little bit hard to give proper commands for the creature. Come eat. Okay. Let's create a
miracle forest.
Forest. I have to watch this animation anytime I'm casting this spell. Okay. Okay. Collect all the wood. Gonna put the creature into a nice behave. What are you doing? Okay, that's good. Let's take him to here and let him cast a couple of spells till I am doing some things. So this is the multitasking part. We need more homes, so we need a lot of wood. As usual. Okay, spell completed. I think I will also create a shield spell. Or maybe not. Let's take the creature here. Okay, I think. Oh, we're gonna learn something. Come here to the field. Yeah. No, I mean like this.
Worshippers must have
food. Okay. And he's gonna poo, I think. At least I hope so. Playful. Let's reward him. I mean, he wanna play. So what now? I missed. I wanna reward him. He has pooed on the field, and this makes it fertilizing. Okay, so what now? Come here. I'm gonna attach him there, and let's create a spell.
Physical shield.
Where are you? There. Okay, let's create this spell.
Congratulations! You are expanding well. Lettuce and better beware. Time is not kind. You need to gain influence in the direction of our common enemy. I strongly encourage you to gain this town. Before I leave to defend my realm, I must tell you one more thing. You will notice you cannot do anything, even cast miracles outside of your influence. However, there is a way using the power of belief. You can reach outside the edge of your realm for short periods of time, but your influence is soon lost until your hand is returned to your realm.
Take the creature. We are on a learn English, but I will change it soon.
Worshippers need food.
Okay, I will do it. Yeah.
Miracle food.
Be nice. Leash is activated.
Worshippers must have food.
Miracle food.
Okay. Just because these shields are depleting my energy, I'm gonna ruin them with this rock. Okay. Thank you.
must build more.
Should be working, right? At least this is what the other god told me. But maybe my people are much stronger than this. Oh, this is not working. Okay, then we will leave those. How are we standing here? Where are you? What are you doing there? Sitting? No, we're gonna do something. Doesn't have much to do. Be nice with the people. Come on. Let's create a hill.
This is my land.
Okay, you're here. Yeah, a lot of believers with one spell. Let's create food.
Miracle food.
Okay. Increase. These are heal spells, basically. Let's create the food here. I'm gonna create one more heal. Yep. Let's put some wood into the storehouse. Seems this doesn't help for them. Or maybe yes. Let's create a shield as well, I think.
Physical shield.
Help me save this land from Nethys.
That had a pretty high effect on the believers. Okay.
Oh man, we're happy!
You are doing well, ally.
Okay, borders are close. It's soon time to attack the enemy, I suppose. And I think soon it will be evening time. So it's time to come home. Let's cast a heal here in the village. Oh, it's pretty far. Yeah, that's right. Okay, I was able to cast it. Creature is coming home. Wonderful. Let's create shield spell. Teleport miracle. Okay. That's also a new one.
No one mentioned me that I can cast that one. What should we do?
Physical shield.
Pretty low knowledge. Okay, what happens if I decrease worshippers? We do not have enough energy and the shields are still active. Okay, that's strange. That's not good. Pick it up. Good boy. Kind and generous. Anytime. Okay, the shields are disabling, I think. That's good. What's the problem? Come to eat because you're hungry. I have a little bit of problem with coordinating things again. Okay, he will eat. I think all the shields are gone, that's great. Then let's increase believers to maybe 50%, that's fine. Creature has eaten something. We are over in the 1 hour video time and my creature is also going to sleep and I will let him just do so. So thank you guys for watching, and if you enjoyed the content, don't forget to like and subscribe, and see you next time on episode 4. Goodbye.